we have a wonderful guest with us tonight, Emmy Award-winning actors of stage and screen. Please welcome Mr. Leslie Jordan.
She was what was known as a bashful blonde, and she was always beautifully turned out when all the other mothers would come to the PTA meeting in their drab house dresses. My mother had her Jackie Kennedy pillbox hat. She had on white gloves, a beautiful little summer suit. I used to sit and watch her get ready. She would do her hair. She wasn't into fads at all, so it was sort of a modified bouffant. It was a very Jackie O with just a little touch of the Supreme. It had this amazing little flip that she would spray within an inch of its life with acronym. Now, when I was little, I collected marbles. Boys my age used to play a game called marbles. I didn't care about the game. I just thought they were beautiful. They were my jewelry. And I would take them to church with me. I had them in a little sack, and I'd count them and look at them. I would make noise, and my mother kept going like this. Now, she would go like this and turn her head, but see, this would move, but this wouldn't. One time, she wasn't looking. I took a marble and put it in her hair. Well, it rolled all the way around and just shot. Anyway, my mother, Miss Peggy Ann, I think when I was little, she and my maternal grandmother was Miss Mary Lucille. Now, Mary Lucille was the best cook in all of Hamilton County. Her red velvet cake could make a Pentecostal put on lipstick. I have seen Baptists get up and dance after eating Miss Mary Lucille's red velvet cake. But my mother, Miss Peggy Ann, and my grandmother, Miss Mary Lucille, I think took one look at little Leslie, and they thought, he's gonna need some help. They circled the wagons, as only good Southern women can do, and they created a secret garden where it was okay for little boys to play with dolls. It was okay for little boys to read Trixie Belden and Nancy Drew instead of those rambunctious Hardy Boys. It was okay for little boys to sew doll clothes and make pot holders. I was very artistic. It was okay for this little boy to do whatever he wanted except, shh, oh no, honey, let's not show daddy. Y'all, my daddy was a lieutenant colonel in the army. I was not exactly the son he envisioned. My poor daddy used to call me son as if he was in deep pain. He would just say, oh, son. My first ambition when I was little, there was a television show. You have to be a certain age to remember this, long before MTV. It was called Hullabaloo. And it featured go-go dancers on white cubes, and I was transfixed. People would ask me when I was little, they said, little boy, what do you want to be when you grow up? Son, you want to be a fireman? What do you want to be, president of the United States? No, I want to be a go-go dancer. That I saw on Hullabaloo, it was going to take some practice. So I would push all the furniture back in the living room, and then I commandeered the coffee table, and that was my go-go, my white cube. And you young people have no idea what we had to go through. We had these things called records. See, it was a round vinyl, and they were in different sizes. And then you had to match the size to the RPMs. You had a little record player, and you'd go from 33 down to here. And then for the 45, which is what I had, you had to get a plastic piece in the middle. And then they had a needle that would go on it. So I had two records that I practiced to. A lot of times on Hullabaloo, they had fast dancing and all the lights were up. And for that one, I had a Wipeout by the Safaris. Do you know they had turned me down for Dancing with the Stars 3 times? I don't know, but if I was y'all, I'd go on Facebook, look for that little campaign, Honey Betty White ain't got nothing on me. And then there was sometimes the lights would go low on Hullabaloo and they'd have kind of like slow dancing in silhouette. And I had a Glenn Campbell, "Where's the Playground, Susie?" And I would press, "Where's the Playground, Susie?" And anyway, my daddy would come home with all of his army buddies. And his firstborn son, now I'm 55 years old, I got a high squeaky voice now. You cannot imagine how high and squeaky my voice was when I was a kid. But I'd see those little old army boys driving up the drive, think, I'm going to show them a thing or two. I said, Daddy, watch me do the party. This very shameful secret. I couldn't tell anybody. It worried me for 2 years from the time I was 6 till I was 8. I couldn't tell. I think I might tell y'all. I might just unburden myself right now, the secret that I carried all those years. I wanted to be Mary Poppins, and Mary Poppins was a girl. And unlike kids today where you can put the DVD in and have them watch it over and over again, 3 trips to see Mary Poppins. My mother took me 3 trips. I knew every song. I knew all the words. They finally found me, thank goodness, I was on the roof, and I had an umbrella. And I was going to make a big jump. I wanted to
find the perfect word. A little spontaneity keeps calm. I'm certain, would have used it in their beds. I'm sure the Roman Empire only entered the abyss because those Latin